Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit. And today we're going to do La Flor Dominicana, LFD, my friends. This is an L300. It is a the cabinet L300. It's very nice, very beautiful. I am not really completely 100% positive of all the tobaccos in there. We got a Legiro, though. The, if you can see that right there, Legiro. Yep. And went onto the site to kind of do a little bit of looking around, figure it out. Really couldn't figure shit out, so we're going to smoke it, and then I'll find a little few more things out. I'll throw that on the screen if I have time. What I could see, their website is decent, nice, but not like a... And I didn't spend a really long time looking at it, but wasn't a ton of breakdown information and stuff like that on the cigars themselves. So I'm going to have to research it just a little bit more, figure some things out. So far, draw, nice. Got a bite to it. Going to pair it with some unsweetened coffee. It's actually warm. And it should pair with this pretty nicely. I believe this should be a stronger cigar. Not too bad. The L300, I think it's a See, that's the thing. It's kind of irritating because I couldn't even figure out all the dimensions, all that crap. I'll find out all that. It'll be on there. You'll see it. You'll probably already saw it. I'll put it on there. And so you'll have all those little intricate details. Sorry, I had a bug on me. Try not to be just a walking post for bugs if I can possibly handle it. I am near the Phoenix airport. I was going to try to find someplace like really close, all that kind of stuff. By the time I left and by the time I got here, I really didn't feel like trying to hunt that spot down, so... And it had been a long time since I've been out here. I don't live that far from this place, but I used to spend a lot of time out here because I used to actually work at the airport. And this is like when I first moved out to Phoenix. But I have some... if I can look at one thing real quick. Bear with me for a minute. Wow. Hope everybody's doing well. It is Saturday, May something. I believe it might be the 17th, I think, today. Not 100% positive, but just want to check something out real quick. Won't take me long. very nice draw on it. It does not seem to be like dry. It's a nice, moist kind of a tobacco there. Sorry, I'm almost going to where I need to be here. I don't think it's gonna happen. This is a pretty strong cigar. Pretty beefy. Come on, here we go. Very, very, there's a few different things. Black coffee, black licorice. All the stuff that I eat all the time. definitely have that one black licorice taste to me, and not like the Twizzler shit. It's that I've said it before in a few other things, but like this, it's this dark black licorice. It's all natural stuff. It's not my favorite, but it's good, but it's really strong. I'm talking about the licorice, not the cigar. I got a plane. There it is. Wow, it was a very strong cigar. It's good. Not a bad one. I was requested to do the Double Zero Digger of the La Flor Dominicana by his YouTube name is Entice Saint. So I'm afraid I'm going to have to let you know that I'm not going to be able to do that. I never have enough time. That cigar is going to take like a good 3 hours, and I don't think I'll ever have that. If I ever do have that much time, I will grab that cigar and I will review that. And I thought I was going to do it like a week ago. Just no way. It's like this big around. It's unbelievable. And I already knew it was, you know, it's a long cigar. But I said, I just don't know if I'll ever have the time to be able to do it. Trust me, I wish that was all. If that's what I could do, is just reviews or stuff like that, I'd be all over it, but right now it's not where it is. So we'll see. Maybe down the road, you never know. I'm not going to slam the door on it, but I am going to just kind of move it over a little bit for right now. This has been a very mild, early spring season, I guess you want to call it, is now heading into summer, and summer is coming up next month, I guess June is when it starts. I don't know for sure when summer actually starts, but we've only had a couple days in the 100 degrees, I think, And other than that, it's been absolutely beautiful. So, a lot more wind than usual. And so I think that's obviously, the weather is doing weird things in all kinds of different places. So, that's how it is. That's how it always is, but it's even worse now. But, very lucky here, that's for sure. Don't have any really harsh stuff, at least right now. I mean, who knows what will happen with, you know, drought type situations, but and the way stuff is changing anyway, we could have, I don't know what we have here. Oh, tornadoes? We don't really, I don't know if there's ever been that. There's been one since I've lived out here, and came out here in 2000, since I moved out here. We've had, in like the Phoenix area, one snow, and that was it. And it melted in like a couple hours. I came out here and picked like the orangest light I could find. This is a real weird place. It's like a business. This is a business park, I think, right out here. There's a couple, some hotels right back here. And I was going to go on top of the parking structure at the airport. I was going to have to pay for that, so sorry. I'm cheap. Just, I don't know what the rates are there, but it could have cost me maybe $10 to do that. I don't know. Probably not that much. Probably just a couple bucks, but. This is how this is going. It's pretty nice little burn line there. Flor Dominicana has pretty good following. They're pretty popular. They've been around. I think y'all have heard about them. And I've had a few. And I knew this one was going to be strong, and it is. But I wanted to, I like to break it up with things that I've had, haven't had ever, all that kind of thing. There's so many out there. And, obviously, there continues to be more and more. And it's like an off-ramp from a highway over here. I didn't really know that. Until I kind of set everything up, and I'm like, oh, well. Not much in the news department, as far as I can tell. We got the, already talked about the draft in my last little thing. No big freaking deal there. I do think it's funny how, you know, they try to make news out of things that really aren't news, like the Rams, they got a, they drafted a guy that's openly gay. So, I mean, who cares? I'm not going to be indulging in anybody's sexual life, whether it's a woman or a man, so who cares? I think the only way I would care what somebody's sexual preference is if I wanted to date them. So, I guess it matters to some people, but to me it doesn't. And I just thought it was funny how they wanted to make it such huge news. Whatever sells, I guess. I'm not saying that it's not saying that it's a non-news deal, because it definitely is. It's something that's never happened, an openly gay man, you know, coming out and everything like that. And he's a great football player. At least he was in college, and he probably has a lot of potential for the NFL. So it does. That's definitely news, but I think it'd be interesting. I wonder how long it's going to take for those kind of things to be non-issues in life. You know, we've continued to do the race thing. Of course, this country, unfortunately, was built that way. There's some really unreal things that should really be taught in schools, in my opinion, but I won't get into it because it's pretty ridiculous. What else? What else is going on here? Other than I could probably, like, fall asleep anytime just like that. And I don't have any problems falling asleep anymore. I need to, I don't know if I need to get more rest. Or if I just, I don't know, if I just work until I wear myself down, I don't know. But it sure feels good to finally sleep. Much darker, much deeper taste. Stronger, getting stronger. It's not a peppery strength. It's more of a, honestly, it's more of a, this is one where a coffee, definitely, if you're going to compare it, a black coffee, you know, a dark coffee, really compares to it pretty well. It's got some bitterness in the middle of my tongue. But it is smoking very nicely. Little ash is holding up. Everybody's prized possession, their ash. The ash has always been my enemy, to be honest with you. Mainly because it always ends up falling on me or falling into my mouth. I think I already, a long time ago, I talked about that. I was driving and had about ash about like this, maybe a little less. And I was driving, and it was nice, so I just had my window down. The wind blew the ash right into my mouth, perfectly right in my mouth. So that was quite a shocker, and it was disgusting. But I always like it when you knock the ash off, and there it is not making some sort of tunnel in there. It's holding up very nicely. No wind, of course, so don't have to worry about the wind effect. So in case anybody out there takes vitamins, supplements, herbs, whatever, anything like that, might do yourself a favor, and if you buy them regularly, especially like if you go to a vitamin store, you know, there's all kinds of different ones out there, Vitamin World, all that kind of crap. Might want to check out Amazon, because I ended up wanting to buy some, and I went ahead and got on Amazon and thought I was buying the same thing that I've been buying at the store here, but it was like $4 less. And so I got two bottles of one, another bottle of another one, and when it came in, it's the same stuff, but it's twice the amount. Instead of being like 200 caps or whatever it is, instead of being 100, it's 200. and it was $4 less. So I was quite pleased and shocked by that. As you can tell, I wasn't really paying attention to exactly how big of a bottle mine was in the first place. So when I got them in, I was like, wow, huge, huge difference. So just in case you do, that's something you might want to look at. And you can save yourself some money and be buying the same product. Definitely, if you do take supplements, you want to be careful what's in them, because a lot of different companies will put in fillers that just don't need to be in there. I mean, not so much that it even hurts your body, which some probably could, but the others, it's a filler that makes it cheaper to make the vitamin, and you're not getting as same nutrition out of the vitamin, the herb, whatever it is. And so you just got to be research that a little and take a look at that. Got to always kind of look at the ingredients of shit. I always hate that. It's really too bad that we can't trust the companies that we're buying stuff from, you know, to be 100% all natural or whatever it might be. But you can't. The taste is very close to the same as a strong Maduro. Lajero, though, different. And these babies, really not too bad. Pretty damn good. If you're a fan of a strong cigar, this one definitely will do well for you. Here in Arizona, I paid $7.80 for it. That is, of course, before the tax man got a hold of it, so it was a little bit more after tax. And I bought it at my favorite tobacconist, which is the I don't know why I almost said this, but I almost said Abraham Lincoln. I think I'm losing my mind. I might be. This might be one of my last reviews. Got it from Ambassador's Cigars out here. And it's in Scottsdale, right on the edge of Scottsdale in Paradise Valley and in Phoenix, right there on the edge. Tell by the colors that is a Southwest jet. I've always loved the whole watching airplanes come in. Ever since I was a kid, I always remember, I still do it too, is I see a plane coming in and I kind of wonder, you know, somebody's either starting a vacation, ending a vacation, ending a business trip, starting a business trip, blah, 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 blah. And I just, you know, there's just all kinds of different people on planes and doing all kinds of different shit. Sounds good. Don't worry, I'm dancing to nothing. There is no music. Actually, I have music in my head from song that was on the radio before I came out, but came out here. This coffee goes with it pretty well. I actually would have liked a little bit. I've been doing really good with not using sugar with my coffee. That's something I used to put quite a bit of sugar in my coffee. And just try to, not so much because it's not the healthiest thing in the world, but I'm trying to, I don't know, lose some more body fat. So that, it helps to get rid of the sugar. If I do, I try to use raw sugar, all that crap, you know, the good stuff, the stuff that's, that is not refined and breaks down in your body differently. But I would have really liked to have had some with this, because I think it would have, a little bit of sweetness on top of this would have been, for me, would have been nice. A lot of people would be like, ugh, for me, nice. Definitely a scotch as far as alcohol goes. You know, like a scotch, a Drambuie. Yeah, I really like Drambuie. It's good stuff. I really like the whiskey with the honey in it. So they got a couple of different ones of those now. One that's been around for a long time is actually, it's called Baron Jaeger. It's getting confused with Jägermeister. And Baron Jaeger is like a honey liqueur, and it's thick, and it's, you swallow it, and it just kind of goes through your sinuses. Really, some good stuff. If I was at home, might be having a bottle of peppermint schnapps with this. Kind of a little bit of coolness, some mintiness. Yeah, it kind of messed with the taste though of the cigar, so I probably wouldn't do that. I try not to do flavored anything, like actual flavored. Sweetened, I can do, but I try not to do anything that's going to mess with the flavor, especially like if I'm doing a review video or whatever. If I'm just hanging out, then, you know, I'll play with it, who cares, but I don't want to fuck my flavor palette out when I'm doing this. I had a question on one of my, on a comment on, I think it was my last review, and asked if, as far as like the box press was a hand rolled cigar. It is. But the main thing I wanted to make sure everybody knows is that I plan on not reviewing any machine made cigars. For me, the whole thing with a cigar in the first place is the whole art of making it from beginning to end, all the way from the people involved that, you know, put their shit all together and figure out what blends they want and where they want the tobacco from and all that. To me, that's just, that's cool, it's fun, and that's it's another form of art, is in my opinion, as far as little human beings that we are. You know, we always, very interesting how we do things. And I mean, maybe if I was more educated, it wouldn't be such a mystery to me. But when I see an engine working, like they lift it up and you see it going and you see all the innards and all the complex crap that goes on just so an engine runs. And we're talking the internal combustion engine, which is, you know, gasoline powered, oil consumption, all that shit. And it's not even, this technology is old, but still it is, how did anybody decide, I got to do this to do that? And it just, people are fucking cool, you know? I've really contributed nothing in this life compared to half the people out there that are really, you know, that think of things. Now, something like this, I could have come up with that. You know, I really could have. Something that does, you know, this kind of thing where you touch something and you get to dial somebody in Japan. I couldn't have. I don't think I could have ever figured that one out. Pretty sure I couldn't have. So, it's pretty, life is pretty freaking crazy. Just the people that worked so hard to get an airplane to fly up into the air, and a giant airplane at that with hundreds of people, big people, luggage, the whole thing. That is an Alaska airplane. Alaskan Airlines. I don't know if I'll ever really take a flight to Alaska. Not a place that I don't want to go, but it will probably be down on a list compared to some other greener territories. I don't know. But again, just you know, a big high five and cheers and everything else to all you inventors out there. I've thought of inventing one thing so far, and I'm not even going to say what it is, because I still might try to put this shit together. But, we'll see what happens with that. But it is not as complex. It's something made from stuff that's already been invented, so it would be just a step up from that. But, it blows me away, you know? We walk around and so many things that are around that we, I think, just don't even think about, you know, that we use day to day. Like, if all technology just stopped and we couldn't use it anymore and we had to reinvent it. I heard somebody talking about this, and I don't remember who it was, so that's kind of where this is coming from right now at this point. But it's like, if all the little plans, all the little blueprints were completely just disappeared, nothing worked anymore, and every car melted, all that kind of shit, everything just melted, was gone. Everybody just standing there. Would we be able to do it? Would we be able to put it all back together? Start over again? I think we would. But I'd be one of the idiots on the line putting the shit together, I guess. I don't know. I am thoroughly amazed still, though. Even the cigar rollers, you know? These are leaves from plants that started from a little seed, planted, grew, cut off. Just all that stuff, and now it's a cigar. Guy, gal, rolls it up, puts it together, they slap a little band on it, they put it in a box, and I buy one out here in Arizona. Pretty cool. I will say, I would definitely recommend this if I was sitting there talking about all kinds of shit and let it go out. More Alaska people. But if you like a strong cigar, and I'm sure most of you, a lot of you who are watching, might know already about these cigars, you know, La Flor Dominicana. They're very well known, I guess, and pretty popular. So this is nothing new. It's just another opinion that you can go by. And say, okay, yeah, bald idiot that talks forever on his, but yeah, he likes them, so. definitely good, definitely nice quality, very, very good rolling. Big thumbs up to the person that rolled my cigar. Thank you very much. And big, huge thumbs up to all of you who decided to watch this. Really appreciate it. I hope you're having a great week, great day, great month, great year. Whatever day or anything else that it is, I just hope you're doing well and life is going good for you. I look forward to hanging with you again. I'm going to relax, have the rest of my coffee, have the rest of this, and just enjoy the rest of my evening. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day or whatever you're doing. Take care of yourself. Thank you again very much for watching. You could have done many other things, and so I really appreciate it. Take care of yourself. Be safe. Be healthy as much as you can. And just keep your eyes open and look for somebody to help every now and then, because everybody could use a little bit of help now and then, a little push, a little helping hand, and it'll come back to you as well. Take care of yourself. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.